In this video, we'll understand how vapor absorption machines work. These machines are commonly referred to as just VAM. Conventional air conditioning systems are mostly vapor compression machines. VAM is similar to these systems but has two distinguishing elements. First, VAM doesn't use a compressor, which is the most energy intensive component of any refrigeration system. This is replaced by an absorber generator unit. Secondly, VAM is powered by heat energy compared to vapor compression machines, which are powered by electrical energy. And solar VAM uses heat from the sun for its energy input. Let's have a look at the key components in this setup. First, we have the refrigerant and the absorbent. The refrigerant being water and the absorbent being lithium bromide. The standard refrigeration cycle components, evaporator and condenser. Evaporator is where the cooling effect will be produced and condenser is where the refrigerant is condensed. Then we have the absorber and generator chillers. These are heat driven chillers which can operate on waste heat, steam and solar heat. Absorption pumps. They are used to pump the solution used in the process from the absorber to the generator. Pumps are also required to pump chilled and cooling water around the system. Solar collectors are used to collect heat energy available from the sun. Cooling towers are used to cool down the hot water rejected from the system. Before we learn the working of an absorption chiller, here are three basic principles which we have to understand. Water boils at different temperatures under different pressures. At atmospheric pressure, water boils at 100 degrees Celsius. At lower pressures, it boils at lower temperatures. Following the same principle, at vacuum or at extremely low pressures, water evaporates without any external heat energy input. Lithium bromide has a chemical affinity to water. That is, it will easily bond with water as soon as it is exposed to it. This process, that is the absorption of water vapor by lithium bromide, is exothermic. That is, it releases heat. When lithium bromide and water are mixed together, we can separate them by just heating the mixture up. Water boils at a much lower temperature than lithium bromide and evaporates, leaving behind a concentrated solution of lithium bromide. We will use the case of a lithium bromide water system to understand the working of solar VAM. Water is the refrigerant used and lithium bromide is the absorbent. We start with the evaporator, where the cooling effect is generated. When the refrigerant, that is water, enters the chamber maintained at near vacuum conditions, it evaporates. The latent heat of evaporation is gathered from the chilled water circulating in the tubes. This heat loss is reflected as a reduction in the temperature of the chilled water, which enters at 12 degrees Celsius and leaves at 7 degrees Celsius. Not all of the water evaporates though. The water which accumulates at the bottom of this chamber is pumped back to the top of the evaporator and sprayed in again until it all evaporates to steam. Moving on to the absorber. Concentrated lithium bromide is made to enter the absorber cell. Due to its high affinity with water, it immediately absorbs the vaporized refrigerant and becomes diluted. This process is exothermic, that is, it releases heat. As the temperature of lithium bromide increases, by property, its affinity to water reduces. A tubed loop of water flowing from the cooling tower is in place to take away heat released in the absorber chamber. The next element in this cycle is the generator. The diluted lithium bromide solution is pumped up to the generator for reconcentration. Here, an external heat source, that is heat from the solar collectors, is used to heat up the solution. The heating process vaporizes water from the solution, thereby increasing the concentration of lithium bromide. The reconcentrated lithium bromide solution is directed to enter the absorber unit, forming a cycle of its own. Water vapor from the generator is not allowed to escape and is directed to a separate chamber called the condenser, where it is stored. This vapor is condensed by bringing it in contact with tubes containing water from the cooling tower. The condensed refrigerant is made to enter the evaporator, where it vaporizes due to the prevailing low pressure conditions while passing over the chilled water tubes. Chilled water loses heat, as we saw earlier, to drop from 12 degrees Celsius to 7 degrees Celsius. This chilled water is used to cool spaces. The absorption chiller thus allows us to chill water from 12 degrees Celsius to 7 degrees Celsius. There are three fundamental benefits which make solar VAMs better than vapor compression systems. They use natural refrigerants like water or ammonia. There are no fluorine gases involved. They use a combination of absorber and generator instead of the compressor, which consumes much lesser energy than the compressor. They are powered by solar thermal energy as opposed to electrical energy.